media headlines this morning. And even as you look at the political climate, the weather is really changing. And on the back page of the Daily Nation, expect heavy rains, warns meteorological department. You've been warned to brace for rains that are expected in several parts of the country until Sunday. Yes. Deputy Director said the rains are expected to be pronounced in some days, mainly in Kisii, Nyamira, Trans Nzoia, Uasin Gishu, Nandi, Laikipia, Nakuru, Narok, Kajiado, Kakamega and Vihiga, as well as the northeast part of the country. Read that and carry your umbrellas as well. Yes, let's wrap up our discussions this morning, and now I want us to go to the other way that NASA wants to ensure new elections are done. NASA has declared that there will be massive demonstrations on the date set for the repeat presidential election. How will that pan out? Governors, and this is on page 10 of the Standard. It's also been highlighted on the front page of the Standard, where Anyang Nyong'o, the governor for Kisumu, now becomes the third governor to declare that there will be no election in that particular county. That story is on page 10. Governors from Kisumu, Siaya, Homa Bay and Migori, those are four counties, have declared no elections will be held in their counties on October 26, looking at also the possibility of mass demonstrations. How does this pan out? What is the hope that and how will these governors ensure that there is no election in their counties? Because we do understand IBC is already preparing to distribute polling material and staff and set up polling stations in all the 40,883 centers.
I would imagine definition of an election taking place is setting up the centers and people turning up and voting, so that you're able to record those who have voted for and against a certain position. And therefore, to persuade people not to turn up and vote is not an illegality. Nobody will tell me it's illegal. It is just an act of persuasion that you are not going to do this business, or I decide on my own that on 26th I'm not turning up at the polling station where I ought to vote, and I'll persuade one or two people. And if
but that's assuming
a number of constituencies don't vote, therefore this election is going to be a nullity.
But that's assuming that everyone in these particular centers supports your position. What if there are other people who show up because they are voting a different way?
Well, that's the political persuasion that we are thinking of engaging in. I'm now talking. Mm-hmm. The way I see it is that no election may mean not allowing people to vote or persuading people not to turn up and vote, and therefore certain centers will record zero. Mm-hmm. And that creates an interpretation that needs a court of law.
Yes.
Because the tally will not be a totality of the 290 constituencies.
You mentioned that stopping people from voting. Do you think that's illegal? That's an electoral offense?
That's what I've said. I've just said clearly that that's an electoral offense, but it is not an election offense for me to persuade you not to turn up to vote.
Okay. Bwana Karanja Kibwage, demonstrations across the country on the 26th, governors declaring that there will be no elections. If at all they're successful and some constituencies do not actually go ahead and conduct this election, as a lawyer, do you think that will present a problem?
Well, first of all, let's admit either we are a country of laws or we are a country of anarchy.
Mm-hmm.
Only in a situation of anarchy, now in a situation of lawlessness, can you even hear statements like governor declares ban on voters. What capacity has he got? What mandate has he been given by law to do that? You see, you know, we are entertaining a situation whereby when it suits us, we are very legal. When it doesn't suit us, we want to be lawless. I want to tell these governors or any other person who is entertaining the thought that you can ban somebody from going to vote, you are committing an offense. And committing an offense means there are sanctions in law.
Mm-hmm.
So when you are sanctioned, then realize you are the author of your problem. That must be very clear. Now, for me, I don't mind you sitting down there and you telling people, I do not see why you should vote. But the decision is yours. That's a very different thing. But when you use the word ban,
mm-hmm.
means you are going to mount
mm-hmm.
a campaign where you are almost saying we will sanction you if you vote.
Okay.
So there is a threat of violence.
What if they use whichever method and ensure, they ensure that there are no elections held in a particular constituency? Does that present a legal problem in as far as the legitimacy of an election?
I want to tell you this. You see, when you talk about legitimacy, the first thing you ask yourself, who is the cause of illegitimacy? And that's why I told you, there is what we call equity. Right? And equity does not and will not expect you.
But if you say that, I'll ask you the same question I asked. What if someone else, Ekuru our court, Cyrus Jirongo, they go to court and say,
when you go to court, judges listen to your case. Alright? You argue your case and judges will listen to you. But I would be surprised that there is a judge today on the bench who is going to listen to you telling him, I caused no election in this particular constituency.
I'm not saying, because you're assuming NASA, these are NASA governors. What if a full our court goes and says,
you may be a NASA governor, but you are not the owner of voters.
My question is, if for any reason we are not able to conduct elections in all the 290 constituencies, maybe two or three, for some reason, maybe demonstrations or something else, does it present a problem in as far as the legitimacy of the process on October 26th?
It does not, as far as I'm concerned. The issue is, you have to ask yourself, before you ask the question, is it legitimate, you ask yourself, what is the cause for the illegitimacy? And if the cause of illegitimacy is you, who is saying that don't hold elections? Because the thing is this, let me tell you. You have talked about Homa Bay, Siaya, Migori, and Kisumu. That's what you've talked about.
Mm-hmm.
And those governors are saying they are allocating themselves the authority to ban. Use the word, that's the word. Ban. What is to ban? Now, then you go to court and say, 20 or 30 constituencies in this particular four counties.
You've avoided my question, because my question is, what if NASA is not the one petitioning? They've caused the problem, but they're not the ones going to court. Someone else goes to court.
But I'm telling you,
who is not to blame for this problem?
And I've said it, and I'm telling you right now, courts are not made of robots. They can see, they can hear what people are doing.
Okay.
Because you cannot keep the country in a perpetual situation of paralysis. And finally, let me address two issues. One, when the withdrawal of NASA candidate took place, there were legal opinions that had been given to the NASA candidate, unfortunately, saying that in 2013, Supreme Court Ryder case said that if a candidate was to withdraw or abandon a position, then there will be fresh election for 90 days. That is the thesis under which Ryder withdrew his candidature. And he thought, because then you remember, Abukati had already said there were only two candidates. He said that now that I have abandoned the position, inevitably there will be no election before 90 days. It happened to have been wrong, because even that position of Article 238(1)(b) that was being quoted doesn't exist in the Constitution.
Mm-hmm.
And the court itself, when it was making that pronouncement, and has never been corrected, it was making a pronouncement on what we call in law obiter dictum. Obiter dictum is an opinion that is given by a judge, and it does not mean that opinion becomes law, because it is not founded on either the law or the Constitution. That should be clear. Secondly, I want to tell Chebukati, Mr. Chebukati, for heaven's sake, go back to the domestic debate of 1976 between Jimmy Carter and Gerald Ford. And when Gerald Ford said the following: a president cannot be everything to everybody, but must be the same thing to everybody. Mr. Chebukati, conduct elections irrespective of the feelings of either Jubilee or NASA. Let the court determine that your elections were either credible or not credible. Mm-hmm. But do not start making pronouncements which make you feel, make the country be in a situation that is not tenable.
Senator, make your final submissions.
Yeah, sure. I think I would like to start with that last question you were fronting to my colleague Karanja Kabage on if the election is not held in all the constituencies. And I know you are referencing that to the provisions of Article 138 that requires that elections will be held in every constituency for a presidential election. But you see, the mandate of IEBC is to conduct the elections, not to force people to come and vote. Mm-hmm. And so as long as there can be put in place by IEBC the provisions, systems and assets that are necessary and the infrastructure to conduct an election that is free, that is fair, that's devoid of either all aspects, as provided for in their own regulations, then they will as well have conducted the election. Mm-hmm. And whether it is 1, 2, 5, 0 people who turn up, 50 people, that is the result. 1,000 people, that is the result.
No one turns up.
Even 0 is the result.
Okay.
Now, secondly, what I wanted to address is very quickly on that issue that you raised on the governance and NASA itself. And I just wanted to remind our viewers this morning the words that finalized or that concluded the judgment that was rendered by Justice Maraga. He said that the orders of this court are this, that the first respondent, who is IEBC, must conduct fresh elections within 60 days in accordance with the law. And so I want to say to NASA and to all the three governors and any other person who may be following in that trajectory, that they are in contempt of court, either to prepare to ban, to even ban as they have said, or to put in place any infrastructure arrangement or plans to stop the election from happening. And if you ask me, actually, I just been thinking that this morning I would consult my lawyer and ask him, can we cite these people for contempt of court already? Because the court's directions are very clear. Okay. that IEBC mm-hmm. must conduct the elections. Let me say also lastly that on the same question, when governors come out and say that there will be no elections in their counties, you need to look at what the powers and functions of a county government and the powers of the governor are. There are no either functions or powers conferred to a governor mm-hmm. to either conduct elections, oversee elections, or even direct on the conduct of elections. So I mean, they're completely off cue when they're talking about elections not being held in their counties. A governor holds a single vote, just like any other voter. Mm-hmm. And there is no voter in a county who is called a county government.
Okay.
So people vote in their own right as individuals.
My request is to, my sentiment is to support the president on saying that let us pray for this country. And as we pray, he said very clearly, let's forgive each other. The mood around this table has not been that of forgiveness. It has been combative mood to go for elections or not to go for elections. My prayer is that let divine providence pour on Raila and the president of this country, so that by the final prayers on the 22nd of this month, the two of them will have seen the wisdom to arrive at amicable solution that can give us a firm foundation to continue the development that we have as a nation. Mm-hmm. It is dangerous and it is not easy. We may be saying 26th is the final day. It may be the beginning of many problems to come.
And on that note, we wrap up our news review this morning. Thank you so much, Kipruto Arap-Kirwa, Deputy Party Leader, ANC, Karanja Kabage, and advocate of the High Court, also political analyst, Kimani Wamatangi, Senator, Kiambu County. That has been my panel this morning, looking at the headlines. Remember, Chef Ali Manbury is still in the house cooking up some breakfast. My name is Freddy Limuli. Good morning.